open doors that I cannot see. Jesus will, Jesus will. Oh, who will make up my decisions for me? Jesus will. When you're feeling lost in the night, when you feel your world just ain't right, call on me, I will be waiting. Count on me, I will be there. Anytime the times get too tough, anytime your best ain't enough, I'll be the one to make it better. I'll be there to protect you, see you through. I'll be there, and there is nothing I won't do.
I will cross the ocean for you. I will go and bring you the moon. I will be your hero, your strength, anything you need. I will be the sun in the sky. I will light your way for all time. Promise you, for you I will.
I will shield your heart from the rain. I will let no harm come your way. Oh, these arms will be your shelter. No, these arms won't let you down. If there is a mountain to move, I will move that mountain for you. I'm here for you, I'm here forever. Fortress, tall and strong. I'll be there for you. I'll stand beside you, right or wrong.
I will cross the ocean for you.
I will cross the ocean.
I will go and bring you the moon. I will be your hero, your strength, anything you need. I will be
of the Lord.
The greatness of the Lord.
Greatness of
Sunday. Please, the Lord needs us.
Thank you. Amen. You gotta hang in there. Some of the senior saints out there, what they doing up there? Amen. It's called praising the Lord. Praising the Lord and they're on the way. Amen. I used to move like that. It was a long time ago, though. Will you pray with me? Eternal God, our Father, Lord, we thank you for this worship experience. Thank you, Father, for all that you're doing with us and for us and through us. Now, God, we thank you for bringing us out to the church house where we can study your word and praise your name. God, we made our way out here long to hear word from you. Have your way, God, in this place. We surrender ourselves unto you. And if by chance, Father, there's one seeking a relationship, if by chance, Father, there's one seeking a church fellowship, if by chance, God, there's one you desire to plant here, we open our arms now to receive them. Thank you for what you're about to do in this place. In Jesus' name we pray. And the church said amen.
Amen,
amen, amen, amen. I want to preach from the book of Joshua, and the reason I'm going to walk through Joshua for the next 3 weeks is we are currently studying Joshua in Bible study, Wednesday at noon and at 7 o'clock in the evening, and I'm hoping that by preaching and paralleling Bible study, you'll be encouraged to come out on Wednesday, both noon or 7 o'clock in the evening. We challenge the 8 o'clock group to come to Bible study. That is where you learn and understand and fully comprehend the word of God. Amen. So bump your neighbor and say, neighbor, you ought to come to Bible study. Now turn around and tell them I'll be there if you get there. Amen. Won't you stand for the reading of God's word? Joshua chapter 3, drop down to verse 14. Reading from the New Living Translation, that should be on the screen behind me as well. 1, 2, 3, let's read. So the people left their camp to cross the Jordan, and the priests who were carrying the Ark of the Covenant went ahead of them. It was the harvest season, and Jordan was overflowing its banks. But as soon as the feet of the priests who were carrying the Ark touched the water at the river's edge, the water above that point began backing up a great distance, away to a town called Adam, and near Zarethan. And the water below that point flowed on to the Dead Sea until the riverbed was dry. Then all the people crossed over near the town of Jericho. Meanwhile, the priests who were carrying the Ark of the Lord's Covenant stood on dry ground in the middle of the riverbed as the people passed by. They waited there until the whole nation of Israel had crossed the Jordan on dry ground. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. I want to preach and teach this morning with this thought in our mind, crossing rivers. Crossing rivers. Now, tell your neighbor, I need to cross this river. Notice now, I didn't say I want to. I didn't say I feel like it. I said, I need to cross this river. Every one of us will have to cross dangerous rivers in our lives in order to experience everything that God has for us in our lives. One of the big lessons that I've learned in life is that nothing really happens while you're standing safely on the riverbank. Nothing exciting happens on the riverbank. No miracles take place. No memories are created. No messages are communicated. No openings are produced for God to step in and show up and show out and do great things. Nothing happens while standing safely on the banks of the river. Something else that I've noticed is many people live their entire lives standing safely on the banks of the river. And then wonder why nothing exceptional, nothing exciting, nothing exhilarating ever happens to them in their lives. But they that wait upon the Lord, you ought to push somebody, say, I'm in that crowd, y'all. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They'll mount up on wings like eagles. They'll run and not be weary. They'll walk and not faint. God has already hung some promises over our lives. And Paul proclaims that all of God's promises are yes and amen. That even when the enemy says no, God says yes. Even when your critics say no, God says yes. Even when your circumstances say no, God says yes. God had directed him to lead them to take possession of what God had already promised them. Second Baptist Church of Elgin, I want you to know this morning that I say without fear of equivocation or successful contradiction that God has already made some promises to us. That God has already promised that by his grace and through his power, we'll be able to change the way that church is done. We'll be able to change and grow this church into an active fellowship of loving believers and who daily praise to God and weekly give to God and every day grow deeper in their love for God. We'll be able to unite thousands of people in prayer, believing that God for incredible victories and amazing things. We will truly become a place where the hurt are bound up, the depressed can look up, the frustrated can help up, the downtrodden can get up, the confused can see their way up. It's all in our promise, y'all. Go on, preach up in here, Nathaniel. See, all we got to do is take possession of what God has already promised. Dr. Sandy Ray, former pastor of Cornerstone Church in Brooklyn, New York, pointed out, see a swelling Jordan. Jordan was at flood stage, but it did not stop Joshua. In verse 6, he says to the priest, take the Ark of the Covenant, cross over before the people. And in verse 8, Joshua says, tell the priest who carry the ark, when they reach the edge of the Jordan waters, go and stand in the river. Don't miss that, y'all. Jordan is at flood stage. It is actually over their head. It is raging. And Joshua says, when you get to the edge, step in. Can I pause there for a minute and ask somebody a question? Have you ever stood on the edge of something that was really scary? Have you ever stood on the edge of a major river crossing in your life? Yeah, like a major interview or like a big presentation at work, like a new career move, a new financial commitment. And the truth was, it really scared you. Maybe you're standing at one right now. And your challenge from God is to move from tipping God to tithing your time, money, and talent. Maybe your challenge is to move from mere church attendance to really significant spiritual involvement. Say, anybody here who's standing on the edge this morning, please hear me well. Our faith journey should periodically lead us to the edge where we are afraid. Because the edge is a place of decision. The edge is a place of transformation. The edge is a place where you get to stand for who you were yesterday and what you want to be tomorrow. The edge is a place where either you have to cross over into something exciting or settle for something that's not expected. Where you got to move forward toward what can be rather than settle for what used to be. But you need to understand that miracles happen in the river. Miracles happen in the heart of danger. Miracles happen just beyond the edge of your ability. Because your extremity initiates God's opportunities. When God wants to do something wonderful, he starts with the difficult. But when God wants to do something spectacular, he starts with the impossible. Let me just share three quick things to remember about crossing rivers in your life. Somebody said, bring it on, preacher man. Number one, you have to be spiritually ready. Yeah, you have to be spiritually ready. The people of Israel were camping along the river at a place called Gilgal. But in verse 5, don't run past that. Joshua tell them, consecrate yourself. Sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do amazing things. Now, what does it mean to consecrate, to sanctify yourself? This is a Hebrew word called kodesh. It means to set apart. It means to get yourself spiritually prepared. Now, how do I do that, Pastor? Well, you start by confessing your sins. I knew it'd be quiet right there. So let me say that again. You start by confessing your sins. See, a lot of us want to confess everybody else's sin. We want to tell them when they are wrong and where they messed up, but that's not going to get you spiritually ready. Because it's easy to live in a glass house and throw bricks at somebody else. But if you want to get yourself spiritually prepared, you have to start by confessing your sins. Because while you're telling God about everybody else, God has the spotlight of the Holy Ghost shining on your mess. You got to confess your sin, but that's not enough. Secondly, you got to renew your mind. That means that you've got to think in a way different than what you've always thought. You've got to clean up your heart. All that bitterness, all that jealousy, envy, hatred, and spite that you've been carrying around like sluggage from week to week. You got to open up the basement and tell the Holy Ghost, go on down in there and clean all that stuff out. In the old school church, they had a song that said, give me a clean heart. It's old school. Y'all don't know it. So I can serve you. Then they said, Lord, fix my heart so that I might be used by you. I'm not worthy of all those blessings, but Lord, give me a clean heart and I will follow you. Psalms 24:3 asks the critical question, who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? And then it answers the same question. The one who has a clean hand and a pure heart. Who has not lifted up his soul to an idol nor sworn deceitfully. That one shall receive blessings from the Lord. The reason this spiritual preparation is so critical. The reason this consecration is imperative. The text says because God is going to do what? Amazing things. Consecration makes you available for God to do amazing things. And I wonder if there's anybody here. If I got about 10 folks up in here who would like something amazing to happen in your life. Is there anybody here who would like God to do something amazing in your life? Amazing in your marriage. Amazing in your finance. Amazing in your home, amazing in your children, amazing on your job, amazing in your church. Is there anybody here who wants to see something amazing? Well, here's your word. You got to make sure that your hands, your head, and your heart are pure before God. God is not concerned about how we look on the outside. He's looking at how ragged we are on the inside. Something else. Secondly, make sure it is the right river. Make sure it is the right river. Joshua sent out 2 spies to make sure it was the right river. See, if you're going to cross dangerous rivers, you got to make sure that it's the right river that you're trying to cross. Be sure you're crossing the right river before you make that decision, before you cross that line, before you quit that job, before you cuss out your supervisor, before you separate from your boyfriend, before you get a divorce, before you say what you plan to say and do what you plan to do, ask yourself, am I sure that this is a river that God wants me to cross? Here's something else, thirdly. You got to expect trouble. Go on, push your neighbor and tell them trouble is on the agenda. That was the wrong neighbor. Tell somebody else trouble is on the agenda. Y'all, river crossing always means trouble. Just because you are following God does not mean it will be easy. In John 16:33, Jesus said, in this world, you will have trouble. But be of good cheer. Don't fall apart. I've already overcome the world. You got to expect to have trouble. Listen, let me flip the script. If your life is trouble-free and always easy, totally insulated and isolated, without problems and without pain, and without any stress at all, that is not a good sign. That might be a sign that you aren't about much. Now, I said it to you in love. It might be a sign that you aren't doing much. You aren't saying much. You aren't trying much. But I heard you, but Pastor, I want everybody to like me. Look, look. If that's the price for me, for you to like me, that I got to be nobody, have nothing, go nowhere, then go hate on me, baby. Because that is not a price that I'm willing to pay. Go on, I need you to tell somebody, take the step. Take the step. Get in the river. Verse 15 says, as soon as they stepped in the river, the water stopped. Wait. When they stepped in the river, when they took the step, God showed up. The river stood up, and the bottom dried up. If you want to see a miracle happen, stop wishing and hoping and take the step. Then watch God work in your life. But nothing happens until you take the step. Faith says, I believe that God brought me here and God can keep me here. So I take the step. Yes. So I step out and I enroll in school. I step out and I apply for that job. I step out and I take that promotion. I step out and I join the church and get baptized. I step out and I go to my child's school that's about to start and I meet my child's teacher and I join the PTO. I step out and I do Bible study. I step out and I try God when it comes to giving and tithing, because nothing happens until you take the step. That's faith in action. God will lead all of us to an edge. You will have a river moment. The question is, will you take the step? Because miracles never happen on the bank. They only happen in the river. In the old school, they had a church song that said, have you any rivers that you think are uncrossable? And have you any mountains that you cannot tunnel through? God specializes in things that seem impossible. And he will do what no other power, Holy Ghost power, can do. God will help you cross any river. God will see you through. I know God will. If he did it before, he can do it again. And y'all, I got to get out of here, but I wish you'd high five somebody and tell them, I got evidence that the Lord will. I got evidence that the Lord is with me. I've got evidence that the Lord is on my side. When you look at where I am, in spite of where I used to be, that ain't nothing but evidence and proof of what God will do. When you look at where I was born, but don't judge me by where you found me, that's just evidence of how good God has been. When you see how the Lord raised me up, that ain't nothing but evidence. When you see how I used to be on crack, now I get high on Christ, I tell you, that ain't nothing but evidence. When I used to get drunk with liquor, and now I get drunk in the Spirit, that ain't nothing but evidence. When I used to sleep here, there, and everywhere, but the Lord slowed me down, y'all, that ain't nothing but evidence. Is there anybody here who can stand on your feet and declare this morning, I got proof, I got evidence that the Lord has been good to me? Wait a minute, wait a minute. Will you tell somebody, I don't want to tear this place up, but look them in the eye. Tell them, neighbor, I don't just have evidence. I am the evidence. I am the proof. Because when you look at me,
You're looking at a miracle. When you look at me, you see what God can do. You see a change. Can I just testify? I haven't always been right. I haven't always lived right. I haven't always done right. But when I look at where the Lord brought me from, I got evidence. When I saw how he changed my life, I got evidence. When I see how he picked me up and turned me around, I am a living testimony. I didn't make it here on my own. I'm not standing here on my own. Child, I should have been dead, sleeping in my grave. It was Jesus, nobody but Jesus. And I don't care what others do. I want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. God, I want to say thank you. God, I want to say thank you. I am a testimony. I am a miracle. I am a wonder worker. That's why I have to shout. That's why I have to sing. That's why I have to lift up hands. That's why I have to praise the Lord when I look back over my life and I start to think things over. I can truly say that the Lord has made a way and I've been blessed. If you know it, why don't you wave your hand? If you know it, push your neighbor. If you know it, just say, yes, 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 yes. So many rivers to cross. But God will bring you through. Eternal God, our Father. Thank you, Master. What we see as rivers, God, you see as a bridge. Thank you, Master. Now, God, keep your hands upon us. Continue to lead us. Continue to guide us. And we'll continue, God, to give you the glory. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Church said amen. 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 Tell your neighbor, I got one more river. But I got to cross. I got to cross it. Mama can't cross it for me. Daddy can't cross it for me. That river's for me to cross. I got one more river to cross. Our young people are going to sing. We're going to extend an invitation. We're going to open the doors of the church. You are not anchored in a church fellowship. We'd love to have you as a part of this fellowship. If you never accepted Christ as your Savior, you're going to need the Lord on your side. Always tell you, we're not a perfect church, but we are striving every day to be more Christ-like. So we're going to invite you to come today. We are the doors of the church. Won't you come? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Master. We invite you to come today. You can come today. Our God is such a good God.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
You can come today.
My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
You can come today.
My hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. My hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Sing my hallelujah.
Sing my hallelujah.
belongs to you.
While she's singing, we invite you down to the altar. Won't you come for prayer? Prayer time in the house of the Lord. We invite you to come.
My hallelujah.